Hi to all, welcome to my class number 2 on chapter 2 linear equation in one variable. Today I am going to discuss exercise 2.2 part 1. Here is the first question. If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number and multiply the result by 1 by 2, you get 1 by 8. What is the number? Here, first check what you want to find out. Here you want to find out the number. Since we don't know the number, we can take it as x. So we can write, let x be the number. Now one condition is given in the question. If you subtract 1 by 2 from a number, that means here the number we took it as x. Subtract 1 by 2 from x, you can write it as x minus 1 by 2. Now, and multiply the result by 1 by 2. Now, you have to multiply this x minus 1 by 2 by 1 by 2. That you can write it as. So, x minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. Then it is given that you get 1 by 8. The answer will be 1 by 8. So you can write equal to 1 by 8. So before that, this we wrote according to this question. So we can write according to the question, x minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 is equal to 1 by 8. Now multiply with 1 by 2 to both x and minus 1 by 2. That means you remove this bracket. So we get x into 1 by 2, x by 2 minus 1 by 2 into 1 by 2, 1 by 4 is equal to 1 by 8. Now here denominators are 2, 4 and 8. So you have to multiply with 8 to all the terms to remove these denominators. So multiply by 8 to all the terms we get. So we can write x by 2 into 8 minus 1 by 4 into 8 is equal to 1 by 8 into 8. Now do cancel 2 and 8 in the first term, 4 and 8 and 8 and 8. So we get 2, 8, 4 times. So 4 into x you will get 4x. 4, 8, 2 times. So minus 2 is equal to 8, 8. 1 times. So is equal to 1. Now transpose 2 to the other side, we get 4x is equal to 1 plus 2, that is 4x is equal to 3, that is x is equal to 3 by 4. So we want to get the number, so we can conclude, therefore the required number is 3 by 4. Here is the next question. The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meter. Its length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. What are the length and breadth of the pool? If you know the length and breadth, you can find out the perimeter of a rectangle by 2 into L plus B. But length and breadth is not given here. Instead, a condition is given. Look at the condition. Here, length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. Twice its breadth means 2 times its breadth, 2 into breadth. Length is 2 more than 2 into breadth. So, length is given in terms of breadth. So, we can take breadth as x. So let x be the breadth of the pool. Now what is its length? Length is 2 meter more than twice its breadth. Twice its breadth. Breadth is equal to x. What is twice its breadth means 2 into x. That is 2x. And length is 2 meter more than 2x. 2 meter more than 2x. You can write it as 2x plus 2. So, we can write the length as Therefore, length of the pole is equal to 2x plus 2, that is twice breadth plus 2. Here, the unit is in meter, so we can write here x meter be the breadth and length is equal to 2x plus 2 meter. Now, what question says? The perimeter of a rectangular swimming pool is 154 meter. So, how will you find out the perimeter? So, according to the question, we can write perimeter of a rectangular perimeter is equal to 154 meter. But what is perimeter? Yes, it is 2 into L plus B. So, we can write 2 into L plus B is equal to 154. Now, substitute the values for length and breadth. Here, length is equal to 2x plus 2, breadth is equal to x. So, we are right. 2 into 2x plus 2 plus x is equal to 154. Now, what is 2x plus x? It is 3x. So, we can write 2 into 3x plus 2 is equal to 154. Now, you can transpose 2 to the other side. 2 into will become divided by. So, we can write 3x plus 2 is equal to 154 divided by 2. That is 3x plus 2 is equal to 77. Now, transpose plus 2 to the other side. Then it will become minus 2. That is 3x is equal to 77 minus 2. That is 3x is equal to 75 and x is equal to 75 by 3, that is equal to 25. Now, what is x? X is breadth. So, you can find out the length also. So, we can conclude breadth of the pole is equal to 25 meter and the length of the pole, it is 2x plus 2, that is 2 into 25 plus 2, 50 plus 2 is equal to 52 meter. The third question is, the base of an isosceles triangle is 4 by 3 centimeter. The perimeter of the triangle is 4, 2 by 15 centimeter. What is the length of either of the remaining equal sides? You know, an isosceles triangle means two sides are equal. Here, equal side is not given. You have to find out the equal sides. Let x be the equal side, then this side also be x, this also x. And the base is given as 4 by 3. And the perimeter also given as 4, 2 by 15. So, we will start with taking x as the length of equal side. So, we can write, let the length of the equal sides be x centimeter. Here, therefore, perimeter is given as 2 by 15. Perimeter means sum of the three sides. So, according to the question, we can write it as x plus 4 by 3 is equal to 4, 2 by 15. Now, x plus x, you can write it as 2x plus 4 by 3. 2x plus 4 by 3 is equal to 4, 2 by 15. 4, 2 by 15, you can write it as 15 into 4 plus 2 by 15. That is 15 into 4, 60. 60 plus 2, 62 by 15. Now, the equation is 2x plus 4 by 3 is equal to 62 by 15. Now, denominator are 3 and 15. LCM is equal to 15. Do multiply by 15. You will get a equation. Then find out the values of x. By solving this equation, you will get h is equal to 7 by 5. That is 1, 2 by 5 centimeter. You can write the conclusion as the each equal side of an isosceles triangle is 1, 2 by 5 centimeter. Do yourself. Here is the question number 4. Sum of two numbers is 95. If one exceeds the other by 15, find the numbers. Here we have two numbers. So one number you can take it as x. So we are right. Let x be one of the number. Now one condition is given in the question. If one exceeds the other by 15, that means one number is 15 more than the other number. One number we took it as x, then other number is 15 more than x. That we can write it as 15 more than the other number means x plus 15. Then the other number is equal to x plus 15. Now what is the condition? Sum of two numbers is 95. That means if you add these two numbers, you will get 95 as answer. So we can write x plus 15 is equal to 95. Here x and x adding, you will get 2x. That is 2x plus 15 is equal to 95. You transpose 15 other side and find out the values of x. So you will get x as, so you get, by solving this, you will get x is equal to 40. Then other number, how will you find out? The other number is x plus 15. That is 40 plus 15, you will get 55. Therefore, you can conclude the numbers are 40 and 55. Do yourself. Here is the question number 5. Two numbers are in the ratio 5 is to 3. If they differ by 18, what are the numbers? The condition for the number is given as 5. The ratio of the number is 5 is to 3. Now we can take this ratio in terms of x. So we can write the numbers are, let the numbers be 4x, so not 4x, 5x and 3x. Since the ratio is 5 is to 3, in terms of x we usually write as 5x and 3x. Now the condition given, they differ by 18, that means difference of these two numbers is equal to 18. So according to the question we can write 5x minus 3x is equal to 18. Now do solve it, you will get it 2x is equal to 18 and x is equal to 18 by 2, 9. Now one number is 5x means 5 into 9. Other number is 3x is equal to 3 into 9. So the answer you can write, first number is equal to 5 into 9, 45. Second number is equal to 3 into 9, 27. So solve the equation and find the values of x and write the conclusion. Here is the next question. Three consecutive integers add up to 51. What are the integers? Now, what is mean by consecutive integers? Consecutive integers are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 12, 13, 14. These are all the examples of consecutive integers. Now, can you say what is consecutive integers? The integers coming in, the integers that follow each other in an order, or they have a difference of 1 between every two numbers. Therefore, let x be one of its number. Then what will be the other number? Yes, it is x plus 1. So right, let the integers be x plus 1. Here three are there. What will be the next? You add 1 to this number, that is x plus 1 plus 1. So it is x plus 2. So here the condition is, if we add all these, you will get 51. So according to the condition, you can write x plus x plus 1 plus x plus 2 is equal to 51. Now here x plus x plus x, that you can write it as 3x. That is 3x plus 1 plus 2 again 3 is equal to 51. Divide throughout by 3, you will get the value of x. Solve this equation yourself. You will get the value of x as x is equal to 16, you will get. Therefore, the numbers are 16, 16 plus 1, 17, and 16 plus 2, 18. Write the conclusion also. Here is a question number 7. The sum of 3 consecutive multiples of 8 is 888. Find the multiples. Now, what are the multiples of 8? Here are the multiples of 8. That is, 1 8s are 8, 2 8s are 16, 3 8s are 24, 32, 40, 48, 56 and 64, and so on. These are the consecutive multiples of 8. Now, if I take a multiple from this, let me take a multiple 40. Now, how do you get the next multiple? From 40, the next multiple is 48, that is 40 plus 8. Next multiple is 56, that is 48 plus 8. That means each multiple you will get by adding 8 to the preceding multiple. That means if you know a multiple, to get the other multiple, you add 8 to that given multiple. If let x be one multiple, then the other multiple, the next multiple will be x plus 8. Now add 8 to this multiple, you will get the third multiple, the next multiple. Therefore, the next multiple is x plus 60. So we can write x plus 8 and x plus 60. Now, according to the given condition, sum of these three multiples is 888. So we can x plus 8 plus x plus 60 is equal to 818. x plus x is 3x, 8 plus 16, 24 is equal to 818. Now you solve yourself and write the values of x. You will get the answer of x as, after solving, you will get x is equal to 288. Now you can write the conclusion as, the first multiple of 8 is equal to 288. Second multiple of 8 is equal to 288 plus 8, that is 296. And third multiple of 8 is equal to 288 plus 16, that is 304. So do all these questions. That is all for today's class. The remaining question we will discuss in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.